Good afternoon, everyone. At this time, I'd like to ask everyone to please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance to be led by Class of 2020 Vice President Esteban Fuentes.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Please remain standing while we continue to honor our country with the singing of the national anthem by Cadet Olivia Reiber.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hail at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Again, good afternoon. Thank you all for joining us today to help us celebrate and recognize the Marine Academy of Science and Technology's graduating class of 2020. I recognize that this is not what you had hoped for, not what you had planned for, and not what you had worked for the past 12 years, but it is what we can do, and it is for you. Before we go any further with today's ceremony, I'd like to quickly take a moment to thank the Monmouth County Vocational School District's Board of Education and our Central Office Administration and the Monmouth County Board of Chosen Freeholders for their continued support of our district, and in particular, this unique specialized high school. I'd also like to thank Mr. Gleason at Communications High School for all of his help putting this graduation video together. And finally, I'd like to thank the PTSA for all you've done to support the class of 2020 and all the students and staff at MAST.
Hello, my name is Tucker Cochran, and this is my graduation speech about the past. I wanted to write this speech as a memorial to what we never had the opportunity to say before leaving. A memorial to the friends that we could never say goodbye to. To the memories of the end of senior year that we never had. To the hysterical laughter with buddies and nostalgic tears of sitting in our last classes that never were. Yes, we lost a lot as a group. I know that it seems unforgiving when a good thing ends, and it's hard to accept the reality that this is really over. Who would have guessed that our last day together would be around a Thursday in March? But the speech I want to write is not just a memorial of what we lost, but a monument to what was. We may have lost 3 months, but the only reason that the lost time was so painful is because the time that we did spend together was so incredible. From the relationships we've made to the myriad of unforgettable experiences, we made the school our home. I refuse to leave MAST without telling the story of the class of 2020 and speaking the voice of the 66 seniors that could never say goodbye. However, our class will not be remembered as those poor seniors who never had their last prom or a real graduation. As a whole, there are just too many impressive qualities and memorable experiences to be defined by something so arbitrary. No, we will be remembered by our creativity. The class of 2020 was rife with outstanding artists, writers, and, most importantly, dreamers. From storytelling sonnets and English journals, to the talented artists of our grade transforming anything into a masterpiece, and even to the multitude of ideas coming from NJROTC leaders on how to improve the program, our class has demonstrated the ability to sculpt the future. We will be remembered by our uniqueness. I cannot think of many places in which you can talk to people from anything ranging from breakout NFL stars to the latest blockbuster movie, and then casually end up to the passive modes of defense of a sea cucumber, which is pretty unique to Mast. We have students with squirrel costumes, at least 4 people that can speak Russian, a couple of harmonica players, and a plentiful population of professional goofballs. It is undeniable that our class is truly one in a million. We will be remembered by a vast collection of genuinely special moments. Freshman Foursquare, Capture the Flag, Super Smash Bros. Tournaments, Walking to See the Seals in Naval Science, the Senior Drive-In, Prom and Naval Ball, Trips on the Blue Sea, moseying on down to the beach after school for some spike ball. The amount of essential moments is boundless. I mean, come on, how many schools exist where they can even do half of that stuff? Even something as simple as the walk outside between classes or sitting under a tree at lunch with your friends is enough to draw out an incalculable number of sentimental memories that are unique to Mast and makes our school special. Humans have this phenomenal gift of arriving in an unfamiliar place and miraculously making that place their home. Regardless of where you come from or where you plan to finish, the unexpected is inevitable, and it is natural for us to adapt to uncomfortable situations in order to make them more comfortable. We all entered Mast with distinctive expectations of what the future would hold for us. We all came to Mast with different goals in mind, from different towns, and with varying degrees of knowledge, and yet, in the end, we miraculously made the school our home. We all had different reasons for coming here, but I've found what matters even more is the reason that we stayed. What matters more is the reason we decided this was the place for us, and no matter what obstacles were thrown our way, we would overcome them with pure, unparalleled passion, because nothing can hold a candle to our strength. It wasn't until I found out that we weren't coming home that I realized the true reason that I stayed at Mast, the people. It took me too long to realize the greatest gift I've ever been given and to enjoy those moments we share. But in those little moments, those unforgettable stages where you can't help but smile when reminiscing, I know that I was making lifelong memories with lifelong friends. Now that the class of 2020 is heading off in 66 different directions, I just wish we had the opportunity to come together one last time and enjoy this family, this home, and all the memories that we made. In the words of Andy Bernard from The Office, I wish there was a way to know you're in the good old days before you've actually left them. We had an extraordinary journey, and even though we were handed a flawed ending, our class was never defeated. There is no doubt in my mind that we made the best of our good old days at Mast before we left them. It just so happens that every great story must come to a close. Even the influential, inspirational, heartwarming, and life-changing story of the class of 2020. The class that could not be defeated. Part of the journey is the end. Thank you.
Now, an official welcome from the Monmouth County Vocational School District Superintendent, Mr. Timothy McCorkle, Board of Education Vice President, Mr. Dennis Ingoglia, and Freeholder Director, Mr. Thomas Arnone.
Good day. On behalf of the Monmouth County Vocational School District, Assistant Superintendent Dr. Charles Ford, School Business Administrator Colette Flatt, and myself, let me be the first to offer congratulations to this year's graduating seniors from the Academy of Allied Health and Science, the Academy of Law and Public Safety, Biotechnology High School, Communications High School, Class Academy, the High Technology High School, and the Marine Academy of Science and Technology. While I know the events over these past few months is not how you expected to finish your senior year, please know that it does not in any way diminish your accomplishments over these past 4 years. You and your families have so much to be proud of. While I know this has been a difficult time for each of you, and your families, graduations are also a time to reflect and to give thanks. What I'd like to do is recognize those individuals and groups who made today possible. to possible, I want to acknowledge the Monmouth County Board of Chosen Freeholders, who supplies so much support to our district. I want to recognize all of the industry partners who provide mentorships and work with all of our programs to keep them current and make them first rate. I want to recognize the parents for your undying love and support of your sons and daughters over these past 4 years, never more seen than in these last 3 months. I have to recognize the staff of all of our schools and the tremendous job they did over these past 4 years, but certainly over these last 3 months as they went to a remote education plan with each of you, while they were all still caring for their families. They have done a tremendous job and deserve our thanks. But most of all, I want to acknowledge you, the class of 2020, and all of your accomplishments. As I said, graduations are a time to give thanks, but they're also a time to reflect. So life does not always go the way you plan or the way you want. You can't always control the events in your life, but you can control how you respond to these events. Philosophers, musicians, poets have spent centuries trying to define and describe what this approach to life is, but I know someone who condensed it into two words: keep smiling. I want to just take a moment, and I'll come back to that, but anyone out there who is listening to these remarks, who works in the healthcare field, law enforcement, transportation, the food industry, skilled labor, communications, biomedical research, is a teacher, and all of the other essential workers who selflessly went to work and continue to go to work so the rest of us can stay home, I want to thank you. You are heroes in my book and deserve our praise. I'd like to tell you about someone else who in his own way is a hero. Not necessarily at the front lines like these people I've just mentioned, but I can say this, none of you, including myself, would be here today if it were not for him. Keep smiling. This individual personifies what it means to live a life in the service to others. He was a son of New Jersey, lived in New Jersey his entire life, and unless you lived in Oceanport, you may never have heard the name of Clem Summers. Clem graduated from the Wolf Hill School in Oceanport. He was president of his eighth grade class. Even then, he showed those leadership skills that he became known for. And a true leader is someone who puts the needs of others in front of their own needs. He was the first Eagle Scout from Troop 58 in Oceanport. He served his country in the Navy and was so severely injured that he spent a year in a body cast. He was expected never to walk again, but walk he did for the next 70 years, and we are all grateful for that. He was a member of the first aid squad in Oceanport, and he still served, up until his death for over 50 years in the Oceanport Fire Department. He served for over 25 years as a councilman, was the mayor of Oceanport, and was a Monmouth County freeholder. His contributions to Oceanport and the county are numerous, but just to name a few, the Police Academy, the Monmouth County Library headquarters in Manalapan, and many other buildings that still exist in Monmouth County and serve the residents of Monmouth County. But by far, Monmouth County Vocational School is his real legacy. He served on our Board of Education for over 40 years, many of those as the president. He built the Career Center. He accepted the Marine Academy of Science and Technology into the district back in 1983, and to this day, worked to see that that campus continued to grow and develop. He started with the administration, but under his leadership, the High Technology High School, Allied Health, Class Academy, Communications High School, the Culinary Arts Program in Asbury Park, Biotech, and the Academy of Law and Public Safety, because he believed that the students of Monmouth County deserved a world-class education, which was second to none. He also loved Michigan football. He spent many Saturdays traveling to Michigan and attending their games. At graduation, he would always look through the program and identify any students who were going to Michigan to offer a few words. So let me share with Biotechnology High School student Kirti Aplash and Krishna Palya that if Mr. Summers was here in my place, he would welcome you to the Michigan family. He'd look forward to seeing you next year, and you will be there with 110 other Michigan fans in what they call the Big House. I think it's important to note that Mr. Summers never had a family member attend Monmouth County Vocational School. His commitment to this district was because he believed in the residents and students of Monmouth County. He did what he did because he was a true public servant. He had three expressions that he always said. The first, everybody he met, if it was a stranger, it didn't matter. He'd always ask if they had started their Christmas shopping yet, which was certainly an icebreaker. Anytime somebody would ask if he needed any help, he would always say he needed a winning lottery ticket. But the most important thing, and everyone who knew Mr. Summers, he ended every conversation, every phone call with the same expression. Keep smiling. Keep smiling. Keep smiling. The world has promise. The world is good. There are things to look forward to in this life, and his legacy, his life's commitment, besides his family and his grandchildren, was to the students of Monmouth County and Monmouth County Vocational School. He often said that Monmouth County Vocational School was the best school district in the country. I believe that's true, but a big part of that was because of the leadership of Clem Summers. To the class of 2020, I present the life of Clem Summers as an example to you of what a life in the service of others can mean, and as an example of a life well lived. To the class of 2020, I say to you, keep smiling. Life will get better. Congratulations, class of 2020, and God bless you.
Hello there, and welcome to our family, friends, guests, and of course, most importantly, our graduates here for all our academies here in Monmouth County. So this is unique times that we never in our wildest dreams would have thought that we would have been engaging in at this time. And I look at when I talk to our graduates or talk about our graduates, I hope this is the last time they ever have to go through this. Unfortunately for them, it's the year that is probably one of the most special years of their life here is that graduation, high school graduation. You know, somebody told me this a while back before when I was talking about this, and I'm a big proponent of trying to find an alternative way to have people in person here, is that, you know, not everybody goes to college. Not everybody moves on to that another level of education, but they move into it progressing in their life. And high school graduations are probably one of the most important component of a young adult's life. So to miss out on it, something you're missing out on in person. But it's our job as administrators and leaders to try to make it as fulfilling as possible. And I guess that will come in this case with words. And so as I talk to the parents and the family members of the graduates, I could tell you, I know this, that you're each and all of you are so proud of these students here. But let me tell you what it is to us here as local officials. And I kind of use it somewhere where we talk a little bit of our political career. And when we go out there and we campaign for elections, and I will tell you that each and every one of our freeholders, myself, Deputy Director Kylie, Freeholder Barry, and Prevedudo and DiRocco, tout our high schools, tout our academies on the benefit that they are. So our graduates, I will tell you, the one thing you do for us is you help us get elected because of your success and your commitment and your dedication. And, you know, I look at what our future is about, and that's important. You know, the feeder part of any organization, and government being one, is the most important part. You're there today. You have leaders today. Whether you like them or not, they're going to be gone, and we're going to need a good feeder program. Whether you're in government, business, whatever that might be, education, that might be, we need people. And you know what? Our future's bright, and I could see that through all our academies. So when I look at our graduates and I talk to our graduates and I see the graduates over the course of the years, I see the bond and the closeness that they have. And I guess one thing I could say to the graduates is you'll move on to your next career and you'll have new friends. You'll build new relationships. But I could almost guarantee that what you will have is a friendship that you have today that you'll never forget. People that you're not even that close with in your high school class, 10 years from now, 20 years from now, you will see that person and say, wow, we went to school together. We went to high school together. It's something you never forget. And at those reunions, it's almost like it was yesterday when you get there. Old times being spoken about, funny jokes, funny times are talked about because they're special times. And they're times that you'll never forget. So remember, you'll cross paths with your fellow classmates. I can guarantee it, one time or another. And when you do, the day how you're graduating at this time of the year will be as special as it is today, will be special when you talk to your fellow classmates years down the road. And on behalf of all of our freeholders, the one thing I can leave you with is Monmouth County, the 630,000 people in Monmouth County are proud of our graduates. And know that your commitment and dedication will continue and hopefully stay here in Monmouth County, will make Monmouth County the great place that it is now, continue to be the great place because of young adults like you. So congratulations on behalf of the freeholders, and God bless.
My name is Dennis Ingolia. I am the Vice President of the Monmouth County Vocational School District. It's a pleasure to be able to speak with you today upon your graduation. I do not have to tell you that the class of 2020 has undergone an extraordinary year. You need only look around you. Instead of the company of your classmates, we meet in a virtual ceremony. But regardless of the nature of today's celebration, it does not dilute nor change the nature of your accomplishments. Graduation is a time-honored rite of passage for young people everywhere. It is an opportunity to look both backward and forward. It is the moment where you may say goodbye to what was and look ahead to what will be. One thing is for certain, you will always remember it. Every generation revels in the stories their parents tell them of their childhood. My dad told me he had to walk 5 miles to school in the snow, uphill, both ways. When you have your children, you will tell them about the great pandemic of 2020, how everybody wore masks, how we kept 6 feet apart, how we sprayed disinfectant on anything that moved, and how your graduation was on a computer screen. The challenges you and your teachers have faced this year have been daunting. not only for the health risks, but for the disconnection from everything that we had taken for granted. But challenges make us stronger. And you, the class of 2020, were the people who adapted and persevered in a time where everything we knew in the entire world seemed to stand on its head. Your achievements and those of your parents who were right there at your side are nothing short of remarkable. You are part of history, and you will be remembered for it. There has been a lot of talk about the new normal. I don't know what that will be, but I do know this. You and your classmates will bring it about. And judging from the way you have handled these difficult times, we shall have no doubt that you will be successful in making the world a better place than where you found it. Recently, we were saddened to learn of the death of our longtime board president, Clement Summers. His hard work and dedication over the years gave this district the national reputation for excellence that it enjoys. His motto was, "Keep smiling," and I can think of no better advice to give you. Along with our sincere congratulations upon your graduation and our best wishes for the future on this happy occasion.
Thank you, Mr. McCorkle, Mr. Ingoglia, and Freeholder Arnone. Continuing the program, we have welcoming remarks from the senior class president, Nick Noe.
Good afternoon, all, and welcome to the graduation ceremony from the Marine Academy of Science and Technology, class of 2020. My name is Nicholas Noe, and I've had the honor and privilege of serving as the class president for this past school year. We are here to celebrate the successes and triumphs of everyone turning their tassels today. Of course, with those successes come downfalls. Due to the state of the world, we are unable to hold an in-person graduation, but don't let that dishearten you. Because even if we can't be together in person, we still see all the hard work everyone has put in, and we are still together in thought. As I stand here in my backyard recording this speech, mere minutes before Ms. Kapp asked me to turn it in, I can't help but to think of the work everyone has done to get where we stand today. Whether that be pulling all-nighters to study physics or cramming before a math test, it is undeniable the work people have put in. On a more serious note, the students that will graduate with today have accomplished incredible things. Things like senior projects ranging from researching marine life or eDNA to building a race car for the EcoCar Marathon, all the way to a racetrack for crabs. The class of 2020 will be attending some of the top schools in the nation, from Ivy League schools to military academies. We also have accomplished the great feat of online learning and doing so with great proficiency. As my fellow classmates have heard me say before, I sign off with love and hope you keep on accomplishing great things. I applaud you all on your tremendous effort to get where you are today, and I hope everyone enjoys today's ceremony. Thank you.
Thank you, Nick. Up next are faculty awards and scholarships. But before we begin these presentations, I'd like to take just a minute to once again recognize Mass teachers and staff members who have helped these students and families of the class of 2020 make it through this difficult time and be here, even remotely, on this graduation day. Mass faculty and staff are truly among the nation's best, and I can assure you that you will not find a more dedicated, compassionate, talented group of professional educators anywhere. These are the people who make Mass the great, nationally recognized program that it is, and without them, doing what they do in their own skilled and personal ways, Mass students would not be able to achieve the level of success they have achieved, and we all owe them our thanks. So from myself and from the Mass families of the class of 2020, faculty, we thank you. And now on to the faculty awards and scholarships. Presenting the awards and representing the faculty of the Marine Academy, the senior class advisor, Ms. Jessica Capodona.
Hello, my name is Jessica Capodona, and I have had the great pleasure of serving as the advisor to the class of 2020. The faculty subject awards are given each year to the students by their teachers for demonstrating exceptional achievement in their respective courses. The following students are receiving recognition this year. For excellence in oceanography, Catherine Wimmer. For environmental science, Ryan Dolan. For sociology, Hannah Grespier. For personal financial literacy, Katie Lynch. For NJROTC, Topher Lusick. For Spanish, Catherine Halsall, Aaron Horback, and Robert Lopes. For AP Physics C, Alyssa Mchentseva. For AP Physics 2, Shane McCutcheon. For AP Calculus AB, Walter Lors. For AP Calculus BC, Victor Fuentes and Aaron Horbeck. For AP Statistics, Alyssa Mchentseva and Dimitri Stepanian. For math, Alyssa Mchentseva. For AP English, Sarah Hanlon, Sydney Kadoma, Katie Lynch, and Esteban Fuentes. For English 4, Courtney McAleese and Yvonne Saz. For Sustainable Society, Sarah Hanlon and Tyler Poland. The three capstone courses offered to seniors for their senior research projects are the culmination of 4 years of study at the Marine Academy. While all of our senior research projects are truly impressive, the awards given out today are for those seniors whose research projects stood out as being truly exceptional and worthy of special recognition. For marine research, Tyler Poland, preliminary assessment of microplastic polymer, and Isabella Fuentes, changes in microplastic abundance in deep sea scallops. Best Design Process Practices for Systems Engineering 2, Mitchell Quinn, Shell Eco Marathon Engine and Propulsion. Best Mentor Practices Systems Engineering 2, Sharath Pettipalli, eDNA, Environmental Collection Apparatus Harness. Best Project Design Directed Field Research, Alexa Kulowick, Ocean Wave and Current Renewable Energy Prototype. Best Mentor Practices, Directed Field Research, Charlie Fish, NOAA Aquaponics Algae Scrubber Prototype. The Brian D. McAndrew Student Achiever Award goes to a student who has distinguished herself not only on the basis of academic achievement, but also for outstanding performance in extracurricular activities and service to the community. This year, the award goes to Rebecca DiStefano. The Caring Award is given to a student who demonstrates outstanding service to their community. This year's recipient is Elizabeth Ellis. The American Association of Women Award recognizes the highest achieving senior female math student. The winner for the class of 2020 is Alyssa Mchenseva. Congratulations to all of our students receiving their awards. Now on to the awarding of scholarships. The Keyport Kiwanis Scholarship is awarded to senior members of the Key Club in recognition of their service, academic achievement, and dedication to community involvement. The award recipients for the class of 2020 are Robert Lopes, Katie Lynch, and Sam Bell. The Jonathan Robert Duchatelier Memorial Scholarship seeks to identify the college-bound graduating senior at MAST who most closely embodies the spirit of Jonathan, a graduate of the class of 2001. It seeks to identify a well-rounded student who is recognized as a leader, an academic achiever, and a great overall person who routinely sets high goals for him or herself. Jonathan also served as a selfless role model for many young children. This year's recipient is Hannah Stone. The National Merit Scholarship is a competitive scholarship awarded to students who score within the top 1% of students nationally on the PSATs. I am pleased to announce that Isabella Fuentes has earned this distinction and has been selected as a winner of this National Merit Scholarship. Each year, the PTSA graciously awards subject area scholarships to graduating seniors based on their academic achievement and excellence in subject-based essay writing. This year's scholarship winners are, for the fields of science, Ashley Chenoweth. For technology, Katie Lynch. For math, Isabella Fuentes. World languages, Robert Lopes. For English, Sarah Hanlon. And for history, Michael Overschwin. Congratulations to all of the award recipients and to all of our seniors for their outstanding achievements in their senior courses this year.
One of the many benefits of Mass NJROTC program, aside from the Naval Science curriculum and the mission itself, is that it gives students exposure to educational and career opportunities they might not have otherwise considered. It is my pleasure at this time to introduce to you the person who will present this year's military appointments and scholarships to the students who have made the decision to both take advantage of those educational opportunities and also made a commitment to serve our country. Presenting this year's Service Academy appointments and ROTC scholarships this year, Senior Naval Science Instructor, Commander Tracy Smith Yeoman, U.S. Navy, retired.
Good afternoon. I'm Commander Tracy Smith Yeoman, and I'm the Senior Naval Science Instructor at MAST. And on behalf of Senior Chief Vaccarella, Chief Featherman, and myself, we'd like to say congratulations to the class of 2020. And we hope that you continue to live out our core values of honor, courage, and commitment. We're so proud of you, and we wish you much luck in the future. It's now my honor to present the NJROTC Area 4 Manager, Commander Jimmy Miller, United States Navy, retired.
Greetings, Superintendent McCorkle, Assistant Superintendent Ford, Ms. Flock, our Senior Naval Science Instructor, Commander Tracy Smith Yeoman, our Naval Science Instructors, Senior Chief Vaccarella and Chief Fetterman, faculty members, families, friends, and especially cadets of the best NJROTC program in Area 4, and in my opinion, and hopefully the opinion of those at headquarters, the best in the world, Marine Academy of Science and Technology. I am honored to have this opportunity to join you on this, your special day. The world looks much different today than when we last saw one another. We have a new enemy, a complicated enemy. However, I am not worried. I am not worried because of young people such as yourselves who are graduating and will take the fight to the enemy in ways that us old folk have never even thought of. Class of 2020, we are so very proud of you. Proud of accomplishments and achievements that you will do on behalf of this great nation and this world. On behalf of Rear Admiral Sands and Mr. Tim Dazzler and the NJROTC family, I salute you. And now I have the special privilege of calling out names of special individuals, special graduates, who have elected to continue to wear one of the fighting uniforms of this great nation. Accepting an appointment to the Naval Academy, Richard Trent Talagi. Accepting an appointment to the Coast Guard Academy, Charles Fish and Tyler Poulin. Accepting an appointment to the Air Force Academy, Sophie Allen. Accepting NJROTC NROTC scholarships, Rebecca DiStefano, Catherine Helsel, Mason Leon, and Christopher Lusick. Accepting Army ROTC scholarships, Ryan Carey and Ryan Dolan. Accepting an Air Force ROTC scholarship, Walter McBride. We want to say hats off to each and every one of the graduates, and especially those who will continue to serve this great nation in whatever uniform you elect, whether it's a military uniform or a first responder or a uniform of a doctor or nurse. Or just a uniform of a suit and tie in a courtroom. We salute you. And we say to you, I say to you, enjoy each and every day. Have fun. Because before you know it, you will be standing up in front of the class of 2050, saying how much fun life was and telling them to do the same. I'll see you in the fleet. Anchors away.
Kurt Vonnegut, the great American author, once said, "True terror is to wake up one morning and discover that your high school class is running the country." While this may seem like a comical statement, it is also the truth with one exception. I have no fear of that day. While Vonnegut was a wise man, I believe this quote would have been different had he gone to the Marine Academy of Science and Technology, especially with the class of 2020. Had he been Cadet Vonnegut, I truly believe he would have said something along the lines of, "The most restful sleep I've ever experienced came after the realization that my high school class was running the world." I can say this with the utmost confidence as I have spent these past 4 years with the amazing people gathered before you today. Looking back on our time together, it seems short. Much shorter than I would have liked it to be, but even still, I know that each one of us has an incredible life ahead, so I will not dwell too much on the past. Instead, let me talk about the present and what is to come. Today is a bittersweet day indeed, as we part ways to walk our separate paths in life. This may be difficult for us at first, but a blessing for the rest of the world. As we take the next steps in our lives, whether to college or directly into the workforce, we are sending 69 incredible young adults into the world. Wherever our journeys take us, each and every Mass graduate will bring nothing but excellence and dedication to their future career. This has been true since the first Mass class of 1981 and will be for as long as you can find the small tan buildings at the end of Sandy Hook. Before I wrote this speech, I made a promise to myself to avoid being cliche, but sometimes there are great truths within well-known analogies. And so with no shame, I will compare Mass to a flower and its seniors to seeds. The winds of fate will carry each of us to our destination in life where we will bloom and grow and yet never forget where we came from. It is our duty as the class of 2020 to spread our roots far and wide, making the biggest impact we can on this earth. Gathered before you today is a group of students unlike any other in the world. Gathered before you are future doctors, scientists, and lawyers. Future officers, engineers, politicians, anything we want to be. Gathered before you are future leaders. Gathered before you is the future, yours and our own. So here's to today. Here's to the end of high school, and here's to a new beginning. Here's to us all and all that we will become. I know goodbyes can be tough, but I know that these young men and women standing before us are tougher. I know for certain that we will all look back on these times with smiles on our faces and warmth in our hearts. I am confident that the Mass Class of 2020 is ready to take on the world and begin to make it our own.
Moving on to the next portion of our program, reminiscences of the Mass Class of 2020.
Hello, Mass Class of 2020. Seems like forever ago when we first formed up on Mastway and our respective companies, worried and excited about what would happen next. Everyone told us that Mast would be a unique high school experience, which we have found out for ourselves time and time again. Freshman year was the time for a new start with a new school and new friends. I'm sure now you can recite the name of every student in your class, but it's crazy to think that there was a time where everyone's names were as foreign as what the term Building 77 meant when it was thrown around at orientation around the first day of school. Freshman year brought with it challenges as well as rewards. For every marine biology test that we took, we climbed aboard the Blue Sea to trawl and develop our love for the ocean. We were all terrified during those first few uniform inspections. But look at where we are now in the battalion. Who would have thought? Freshman year was the year of firsts. First time meeting people who would become our lifelong friends. First page in this new chapter of life. And the first bag of Miss Max cookies. Now we are at the end of our high school career, and freshman year seems like a distant memory. Let's look back on some fun memories we made during our first year at Mast.
My name is Gian Tadaro, and today I'll be reading a short speech about our sophomore year at Mast. Sophomore year was truly an in-between. We were finally settled into the flow of Mast, but for most of us, not stressing over college just yet. Sophomore year almost seems like a blur, but was still rather eventful. It was the year that we built cardboard kayaks and tried to sail them. We got to showcase our creativity and held a successful art auction. We planned road trips and built covered wagons for the Oregon Trail. It was the year that we took chemistry boat trips, learned not to write in blue pen, and always said, GCF first. And although our classes were very important, there was much more to sophomore year than just them. We had more opportunities to bond together as a class, like when we took a trip to the USS New Jersey while some of us were still on color guard. It was also the first year we held our annual naval ball at Jumping Brook. One of my favorite memories from sophomore year was during our campouts, when we got to play manhunt on campus, and we got to discover Sandy Hook in the dark. Sophomore year may have flown by, just like every other year, but it's still an instrumental part of our Mast experience.
Thank you. In terms of significance, it's usually hard to top senior year. Everybody's discovering what the future holds for them, and the departure of a familiar place has everlasting effects. However, given that our senior year was cut short right before we arrived at what was allegedly the most exciting part, I've come to realize that junior year may have actually been more memorable. I like to categorize the years by relevance. Seniors are the leaders, and everyone counts them to be role models. Freshmen are the new kids on the block, unsure of their surroundings, with everyone keeping a close eye on their worthiness. Sophomores are mostly relevant. Juniors, however, have more responsibility than most people think. Teachers seem to find a nice contrast between, you're almost seniors, you need to start acting like it, and, in contrast, you're not seniors yet, so don't act like you run this place. Junior year is the year of college preparation, standardized testing, teachers piling on the workload, and the shifting of leadership. It was stressful to say the least, and, in my level-headed opinion, the best way to combat stress is to have as much fun as possible. I'd say we did an outstanding job. Following our fearless leaders, Battalion Commander William Perry and Class President Jack Nolan, we entered junior year with ferocity. Activities such as spike ball, powder puff, volleyball, and athletic bees were fantastic ways to demonstrate our awesome athletic abilities. On another front, our class consistently commanded in Super Smash Bros. And Jeopardy. They tried to hold us back by sending us on a ridiculous number of trips. The R trip to New York, full-day boat trips, a nice trip to Broadway, and several trips to Brookdale. I have said the word trips several times despite its many synonyms to emphasize the fact that they just wanted to get rid of us. However, nothing can stand in the way of our dominance, and more importantly, nothing could prevent our buffoonery. Plastic spoon hysteria was inevitable, and Young Gravy dropping the musical masterpiece Sensational only fed the flames of our foolery. We were soon rising to the top of the ladder, not to mention that we finally started driving to school. Junior year is when we began to seize control of leadership positions across the board, including clubs and the battalion. Although we suffered heavy losses with the departure of Mr. Zarata, Mrs. Johns, Miss McLaughlin, and Miss McD, we finished the year stronger than ever. It's sad to say that we never held our own senior prom, but the prom of junior year was still a fantastic experience. We may not have had the senior year we were looking for, but I think it's safe to say that junior year was so eventful and memorable that it just might make up for it. I mean, think about it. Why were we all so upset about the lost time? It's because we were all hoping that senior year would have the potential to match such an outstanding junior year.
Stop!
Our senior year was set to be the best year of our time at MAST. After climbing through the ranks, we met the climax of our high school career. Unfortunately, it was cut short. On March 12th, we had our last day of school together due to the COVID-19 outbreak, but even in the time we had together, I'm sure we all have made lasting memories. Starting the year with our senior drive-in, we kicked off the new school year, horns honking and engines revving. We began Clash the Classes, where we destroyed the competition, taking first place. At AMI, we proved we were the best unit in Area 4. We all worked on our senior capstone projects in different courses. We had senior redesigns where we painted with Bob Ross and had our Thanksgiving feast. More recently, we all found out where we are going to college and will be spending the next years of our life. I hope everyone has had a happy and successful college career and that you remember your time at MAST.
Now the moment we've all been waiting for, the awarding of the diplomas. Mr. McCorkle, Mr. Ngoglia, Mr. Arnone, I hereby certify that the students before you have completed the requirements set forth by the Board of Education and the New Jersey State Department of Education to receive a high school diploma. Sophie Renee Allen. Alyssa Amchentseva. Cameron Craig Ballard. Nick Barazzotti. Tyler Edward Barkey. Catherine Elizabeth Barone. Samantha Bell. Elena Lauren Boisvert. Sean Burke. Ryan Carey. Ashley Rose Chenoweth. Tucker James Cochran. Cameron Craig. Elizabeth Dalbero. Charles Nikolai Demery Edwards. Sandra Nicola Dada. Rebecca Angelina DiStefano. Joe Dewar. Ryan Thomas Dolan. Kathleen Erin Donnelly. Elizabeth Ann Ellis. Michael Thayer Faulkner. Charles Leslie Fish. Esteban Fuentes. Isabella Fuentes. Victor Fuentes. Mia Chrislin Grunbaum. Hannah Grusbier. Catherine Halsall. Sarah Helen Hanlon. Scott Harrington. Erin Catherine Horbax. Ryan Huang. Sydney Alyssa Hope Kadama. Zoe Marie Kakowski. Alexa Kulowick. Damian Matthew Leck. Mason Tiberius Leong. Daniel Matthew Lewis. Robert James Lopes. Christopher Joseph John Lusick. Walter Cupper Lures. Catherine Rose Lynch. Courtney McAleese. Walter Ryan McBride. Shane Arthur McCutcheon. Mary Newman. Callie Rose Niederer. Nicholas Jasper Noe. Michael Oberschuhen. Sharath Chandra Pettipalli. James Plisky. Tyler Scott Polin. Harrison Hatem Quinn. Mitchell Hatem Quinn. Douglas Scales. Tommy Schuster. Dimitri Alex Stepanian. Hannah Stone. Yvonne Dennis Saz. Gianna Tadero. Richie Trentelage. William Visconti. Rachel Warnett. Catherine Cullen Wimmer. The turning of the tassels will be led this year by the Class of 2020 Sergeant-at-Arms, Dimitri Stepanian.
Class of 2020, you may now turn your tassels. Congratulations.
Thank you, Dimitri. And congratulations to the graduates and families of the Marine Academy of Science and Technology, Class of 2020. And now, closing remarks from the Class of 2020.
When I was little, my mom always told me to reach for the stars, even if they seemed a little too big or too far away. My younger self probably never imagined that I would be where I am today, looking forward as I close the chapter of one book and start a new one. But in a time of great uncertainty, it is difficult to look to the future. We don't know what is going to happen tomorrow, let alone in 6 months or even 6 years. After today, all of us will be going in different directions. From New Jersey to Florida, Canada, Tennessee, and everywhere in between, we will leave masks behind us and embark on new adventures. Although it is important to look back on these past 4 years, it is equally important to think about the future as we enter the next stage in our lives. We must be confident in the fact that MAST has prepared us for what lies ahead. From the hours of calculus practice problems to writing essay after essay for English and the annual sleepless night before AMI, all of these experiences served a purpose, whether we realize it or not. As we enter college and our future careers, we will face challenges and adversity. It is during these times that we must reflect on what MAST has taught us and stay true to our values. I have no doubt that we have the perseverance and determination to conquer these challenges, accomplish our goals, and make an impact on the world in the process. In our society, it is too easy to become overwhelmed with ideals of success and perfection. However, we must not be afraid of imperfections or failures, but rather eager to learn from them. We must find bad ideas before we can find good ones, and we must play the wrong note to realize how wonderful the right note sounds. We are too busy chasing perfection to realize the beauty in imperfections. The best things in life are imperfect, and so are we. Define success for yourself, and do not let anyone else's opinions prevent you from reaching your full potential. There's always a new adventure beyond the horizon, whether that be the chance to study abroad, the opportunity to travel the world, or simply the ability to try something new that you've never done before. We must take advantage of these adventures and embrace the uncertainty of life. No one knows what the future will hold, but this is what I can tell you. Our paths will not be straight. The world will throw many things at us. There will be people who try to tear us down, but we must surround ourselves with people who will build us up. Stay positive, work hard, be fearless, shoot for the stars, and dream big. In the words of Eleanor Roosevelt, the future belongs to those who believe in the beauty of their dreams. Thank you.
We will conclude today's ceremony with our traditional senior video presented by 2020 graduate Aaron Horbach.
Good afternoon, everyone, and congratulations, class of 2020. I know that this year is not ending the way we imagined, and some may feel that this situation has taken away from our high school experience. However, I do not feel that these unfortunate circumstances have made the memory of our time at MAST any less remarkable. I believe that the time we've spent together is not represented by the final moments. It's the result of all the moments that led to this point. It was the memories we made and the people we met that made these past 4 years so special. Our graduation from high school is not only a huge accomplishment, but also an important milestone. Throughout these past 4 years, we have talked and dreamed of the future with excitement in our hearts, determination in our minds, and confidence in our spirits. We have developed our talents and discovered our passions with the experiences we have had both in and out of the classroom. And now, as our graduation from high school marks the end of this chapter of our lives, we move forward into the world with its endless possibilities and opportunities, using everything we have learned to turn our dreams and ambitions into reality. I'm so thankful to have gotten to know all of you and to have been part of the MAST community. I know I speak for everyone when I say that I'm proud to have gone to such an incredible school and that I will always look back on these 4 years as some of the most unique and exciting times of my life. I want to thank all the staff, teachers, and parents for everything they've done for us throughout the years. They've been the driving forces of our success, believing in us even when we questioned ourselves. Even now during these difficult times, they constantly go out of their way to celebrate us and restore some of the joy of senior year. I also want to thank all of you for making the class of 2020 the most supportive, welcoming, and overall best class at MAST, and for giving each other the best 4 years of our teenage lives. Congratulations again to everyone. I know you'll all find success and happiness in whatever path you take next. Take pride in how far you've come and have faith in how far you can go as you set off to find the next adventure. Show the world what you can do.
pretty good place. But Big Tom, Miss John, they just made me crack up on even the darkest days.
We want to thank all the teachers, but especially Mrs. Kaiser, for all of her support.
Thank you for hosting all of our poetry teas and Creative Arts Club and GSA meetings.
We appreciate all that you do.
I would like to thank all of the faculty members who have always guided all of us along the way and who have always just offered their continuous support to every member of the class of 2020. Also, on behalf of myself as well as Kate, I would like to make a special shout out to Miss Opito, Chief, and Big Tom for always putting up with all of our shenanigans. Thank you all.
Gracias, Senor. I always had the best time in your class and the biggest laughs. Your ability to keep us engaged was integral for my growing love in Spanish culture and language. Thank you to the best English department in Monmouth County. To be able to instill interest and excitement into literature is not easy, but Mrs. Trinidad, Kaiser, Johns, and Wardlow always knew how to engage us. Thank you to all teachers for supporting, encouraging, and pushing us to be our best over the last 4 years.
Hi, Ms. Obito. You helped me through my worst times, and because of that, I was able to have the best 4 years of my life. You'll never understand how much all those hours spent in your office meant to me. Thank you.
I just want to give a shout out to all the teachers who have helped us over the past 4 years. You've really challenged us, but sculpted our futures. I want to say thank you, and we're all going to miss you very much.
I want to thank Ms. Ong and Ms. Baskin for being such great teachers to me throughout my years at MAST. Both of you helped coach Envirothon and Ocean Bowl, both of which were very important experiences to me, and I really appreciate that.
Thank you.
Thank you for watching, everyone. Good luck, be safe, and be well.